Good morning. We're here at Growing Hunter Beef, Hunter Local Land Services' inaugural regional beef forum for the Hunter Valley and Manning Great Lakes. With me today is Mark Inglis from JBS. Mark's one of our keynote presenters today. He's going to talk a little bit about making sure you're breeding for the right market. So tell us a little bit about what JBS wants to tell the producers here in the Hunter.
Yeah, I suppose it's not necessarily about JBS, but it's about all markets that you supply into. So making sure that we're actually breeding and also supplying an animal that's fit for purpose at the other end. I mean, we operate around grids in the JBS and we have really clear, transparent indicators about what the type of animal that we want. So making sure you hit that mark.
In days gone past, people bred to sell at their local cattle market. They bred for the weekly or monthly markets. Things are very different now. There's a lot of things people have got to really target. They've really got to look at what they're doing at the top end to get the back end come through.
Yeah, exactly right. I mean, what we are now seeing is probably the sale yard is not really the indicator for a type of market. You know, we're seeing a lot more producers and processors linking up in supply chains and really targeting an end user on an end market with it. So, producers need to be over that. They need to know about what their options are rather than just breeding an animal and hoping that it's going to fit a market out the other end.
What are the options for Hunter Valley producers? We've seen a tough time over the last 18 months, 2 years even. People are looking at their options. What are the best options to be looking at if you're looking at improving your breeding stock?
Yeah, look, so from our perspective, we're very heavily into 75-80% of what we do is the certified grass-fed program that we run. And, we're looking for a 300 kilo carcass animal. We want it to have, a 1B through to 3 meat colour. We want it to have a 0 to 3 fat colour. We want it to be an index, an MSA index over 55. So we really know what we want from an outcome. It's just about communicating that back to producers.
How easy is that to achieve? How does someone just go and say, I want that animal? How many generations does it take to get to that point?
Look, I think the great thing about it is that we haven't gone too far like some other countries around the world. We still have animals that perform on grass and perform exceptionally well on grass. You know, if you look across our branding strategy, we've got grass-fed beef that sit in the top 1% of all eating quality animals in Australia. We have animals that sit in the top 5% and we have animals that sit in the top 10%. We don't see too many under that. So British bred type animal, high marbling, good weight for age, so I mean low os and high weights, they'll give you exactly what we want. So we know they're there, so it's just about choosing and picking out those right type of genetics to supply into that.
For an average punter though, how do they, start at this? It sounds a big thing to go looking at maybe what they've got in their paddock now to then say they want to get into those top ends of the grid. There is a bit of a journey.
Yeah, there is, absolutely. I think the best thing is to have a crack and then get some feedback back on them. So, talk with your buyers, doesn't matter, who you supply with, and get an indication of what they want and then match it up to your results. The great thing about going forward now is that we've got some really great tools in the beef and lamb industry, like Livestock Data Link, like MyMSA, that can really give you the insights into what you've actually got, and then you can match that up to what the processor actually wants.
And so from here on today, your advice to local producers looking for their options is?
It is actually get out and inquire about it. Don't just look at the sale yard as an option. There's plenty of other options around whether it's a feeder steer, whether it's a supermarket domestic, or whether it's supplying into the actual certified grass-fed program.
Thanks so much for your time, Mark.
No worries. Thanks, Patty.